Hello friends, a warm welcome to yet another interesting session on instrumentation and control in power plant industries. Our today's topic of discussion is differential pressure flow meters. Differential pressure flow meters are also called differential flow meters or DP flow meters. In today's session, we will be discussing about what is differential pressure flow meter, how does it work, its basic principle, then what are its different parts in industry, what different type of DP flow meters are used, and particularly in what application they are used, their advantages, disadvantages, and much more. So to start with, our first question in mind is, what is differential pressure flow meter? So differential pressure flow meter. So as the name itself clears, it is a flow meter that is measuring flow. And the principle employed is by measuring differential pressure. Now coming to its details, differential pressure flow meter works on the principle of partially obstructing the flow in the pipeline. This creates difference in the static pressure between the upstream and downstream side of the device. This difference in the static pressure, referred to as differential pressure, is measured and is used to determine the flow rate. Now, these are the most popular choice in power plant industries. Almost 40% of the industrial flow meters in use at present are differential pressure flow meters, with the orifice plate being the most popular. DP flow meters are used in wide applications, including liquids, gases, and even highly viscous fluids. And the main reason is their simple design and low cost. Further in this session, we will have a much clearer idea of their benefits, viable metering options, and applications for using differential pressure flow meters. Coming to its working principle, its history is quite old. In 18th century, Daniel Bernoulli discovered that the pressure and velocity of fluid are inversely proportional to each other. That means, as the speed of a moving fluid increases, the pressure within the fluid decreases, and vice versa. This principle gave the idea of measuring fluid flow rate by using the DP created by the flowing fluid across a flow restriction in the pipeline. First, I'll explain the principle for orifice plate flow meter. Then we can easily extend the same for other types of flow meters like venturi, flow nozzle, pitot tube, and annuba. Basically, it is an inline instrument that is installed between two pipe flanges. The orifice plate of the flow meter comprises of circular metal disc with a specific hole diameter that reduces the fluid flow in the pipe. And pressure taps are added on each side of the orifice plate, that is upstream and downstream of the orifice plate, to measure the pressure differential. Due to the flow restriction, in this case, this orifice plate, the fluid flowing strikes with the plate and passes through its hole. Then after some distance, again regains its full shape. Here in this figure, we can see before orifice plate, the fluid has full pipe cross section to flow. But just immediate downstream of the orifice plate and up to certain distance, the fluid flowing area is not regained to its maximum width, rather it's limited. Here, upstream side, we have taken tapping 1, approximately 1D distance upstream of this orifice plate, where D is the diameter of the pipe. At this tapping 1, the fluid is flowing with full area equal to the pipe diameter. And second tapping is taken approximately D by 2 distance downstream of the orifice plate. At the second tapping point, the fluid is having maximum constriction. That is the minimum cross-sectional area. This point is very important, that downstream of this orifice plate, this point where we have maximum constriction, that means the minimum flow area, this point is called vena contracta. So tapping 1, maximum area, tapping 2, minimum area. Now we know fluid flow rate is equal to area into velocity. So you can easily judge, as the area is high at tapping 1, so velocity is low, and at tapping 2, that is downstream of the orifice plate, area is low, so velocity is high. Clear? So the fluid flow rate can be easily calculated as the change in the fluid velocity. Means fluid flow rate is directly proportional to downstream velocity minus upstream velocity. Moreover, as we discussed in 18th century, Daniel Bernoulli has already proved that velocity and pressure are inversely proportional to each other. Means if one increases, then other decreases. And in our case, velocity is increased, so pressure is getting decreased. Clear? So thus, the pressure of the fluid at the downstream side of the orifice plate is less than the incoming side due to the accelerated flow. Means upstream the orifice plate, it's high pressure, we can say HP side, and downstream the orifice plate we have low pressure, LP side. Thus we can say that flow is proportional to upstream pressure minus downstream pressure, or in short, fluid flow rate is proportional to differential pressure across the flow restriction. To be more precise, flow rate is directly proportional to square root of this differential pressure. Now coming to the various types of orifice plates, we have concentric, eccentric, and segmented. So our first type is concentric orifice plates, which are having centrally bored hole. It is used in variety of applications including clean liquids, gases, and steam calculations. It is generally made up of stainless steel, but in case of highly corrosive in case of the corrosive materials, nickel and monel are also used. Centric type orifice plates are the most accurate orifice plates, but these cannot be used in slurries and highly corrosive operations. Our second type is eccentric orifice plate. Here in this picture we can see that this hole is not at the center of this orifice plate, rather it is off centered. This off center aperture makes them suitable for fluids having suspended solid particles. Our third type of orifice plate are segmented orifice plates. Here, clear from the picture that the hole is not completely circular, rather a concentric circular segment is there. These types are used where fluid contains non-abrasive containments such as sewage treatment plant, chemical, paper, or petrochemical industries. So orifice plates we have already covered. Our next type of DP type flow meters are Venturi flow meters. Venturi flow meters, we can see that in orifice plate, the second tapping, that is the low pressure tapping, was downstream of the orifice plate. But in case of Venturi, it is exactly at this throat, the narrow portion of this Venturi flow meter. So its application rest working wise, it is similar to orifice plate. That means DP is measured high pressure, low pressure, and flow is directly proportional to square root of that DP. Its application, it is used where high pressure recovery is required. It can be used for measuring flow rates of water, gases, suspended solids, slurries, and dirty liquids. It can be used to measure high flow rates in pipes having diameters in a few meters, means bigger size pipes with high flow rates it is used. It has many advantages, like less chances of getting clogged with sediments. Their coefficient of discharge is high, and we can predict perfectly the behavior of venturiflometers. Its installation wise, it can be installed vertically, horizontally, or inclined. The pressure drop is very low, approximately 10% of the delta P, and its lower sensitivity to installation effects as compared to orifice plate, and less susceptibility to damage, more suitable for gas flows with entrained liquids. They have disadvantages too, and the first and foremost disadvantage is their size. They are very big in size, hence where space is limited, they cannot be used. Second is their cost. Not only their initial cost, they have high installation and high maintenance cost also. Next is their state length requirement. Venturiflometers need high state pipes basically to avoid turbulence in flow for their satisfactory operation. And their manufacturing cost is high. They are susceptible to tapping error in case of high Reynolds number gas flows owing to high fluid velocity passing through this pressure tapping at the throat. Throat is this narrow portion of this venturi tube. So coming to our next type of flow meter, it's flow nozzles. Flow nozzles are generally used where the liquid discharges into the atmosphere. It is also used in situations where suspended solids have the property of settling, and it is widely used in high pressure and temperature steam flows. Their advantages are installation is easy and cheaper as compared to venturi meter. Please mind it, here I am comparing that installation is easier and cheaper as compared to venturi meter, but it is difficult as compared to orifice flow meter, because orifice are the easiest and cheapest. Then flow nozzles are very compact, has high coefficient of discharge. Disadvantages wise, pressure recovery is low, maintenance is high, and we have already discussed that installation is difficult as compared to orifice flow meter. Next is pitot tube. In industry, pitot tubes are in power plant industry, pitot tubes are rarely used, but these are named after Henry Pitot. In 1700s, he used a bent glass tube to measure velocity in river in France. Pitot tubes can be very simple device with no moving parts, used to measure flow velocities. Pitot tubes are a common type of insertion flow meters. Here we can see the holes are there. Direct fluid side, it is high pressure. Opposite side of this tube is low pressure, and then DP is measured, or it can be used as this. One is in the facing the fluid, which is having high pressure side, and then another is static pressure side, and then the DP between the two legs is measured. So it's occasional application wise, it's occasionally used to provide an indication of flow rate. It is used in aircrafts, not in power plant industries. It is used in aircraft to measure airflow velocities. Its advantages is it presents very little resistance to flow. It is inexpensive to buy. Simple types can be used on different diameter pipes. And disadvantages wise, the turn down ratio is limited to approximately 4:1. Why? Because of the square root relationship between the pressure and the velocity. And in case the steam is wet, the bottom holes of this pitot tube become effectively blocked, and these are sensitive to changes in turbulence and needs careful installation and maintenance. Next, coming to our NU bars. NU bars have the advantages like this can be inserted. These are again insertion type, and this can be inserted in small openings. This can be used to sample the velocity at several points, and they have low pressure drop and minimal obstruction basically. But the disadvantage is single point measurement, pitot tube is fragile, and DP signal is low, weak signal basically. So friends, this was all about our DP type flow meters, their principles, their applications, their limitation, and their specific installations. So hope I am able to clear the concept well. We will meet you in our next video. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy, take care. Bye.